When you first fall in love, it's a whirlwind of crazy emotions and obsession and anxiety, and then eventually it's not. So, did you fall out of love, or did it turn into something new? Hey there, loved ones. Julian here for D News. If you've ever fallen in love, you know it does all sorts of odd things to you. Your palms get sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. You tell her you can cook, but you can only make spaghetti. At first, it's totally exhilarating. Then, over time, you get more comfortable, but no less in love. What's changed inside your brain? Why does young love feel so different than old love? Scientists have wondered the same thing, and they've used fMRI machines to peer into people's brains and find out what's happening when you first tumble head over heels for someone. It turns out love feels so good because it makes two regions of your brain light up, the caudate nucleus and the ventral tegmental area. Both these regions are associated with reward and pleasure because they're rich in dopamine. But dopamine isn't the only neurotransmitter giving you that distinct new love feel. Oxytocin and vasopressin are mixed into the mental cocktail too. Oxytocin is released after sex or skin-to-skin contact and produces feelings of contentment and security, bringing couples closer together. Vasopressin is also associated with long-term bonding. New love doesn't just amplify neurotransmitters, it reduces some too. When you're in that phase, your body releases a hormone, cortisol, also known as the stress hormone. As cortisol levels rise in the body, serotonin levels in the brain go down. As a neurotransmitter, serotonin helps relay messages from one area of the brain to another, and Harvard Medical School's Richard Schwartz says its depletion causes those intrusive, maddening thoughts you have when you're in the early stages of love. It's what causes infatuation and obsession. And finally, new love can shut down some neural pathways altogether, particularly the one that connects the nucleus accumbens to the amygdala. That pathway is associated with fear and social judgment and helps us make critical assessments of people. Ever fallen in love with someone who was objectively terrible and then later wondered why you didn't see it? Well, now you know why. Over time, some of these chemical levels change. Your body stops pumping out cortisol and your serotonin levels come back up. That's why that anxiety goes away and you stop worrying about how you look or if you're coming off as too needy. And you actually become less needy because the higher levels of serotonin make you less obsessive. Your brain and body are less stressed and you stop feeling that manic craving for your romantic partner. But that doesn't mean you can't be madly in love with someone, even after decades. Since oxytocin levels are boosted after sex, those can be brought back up at any time with a roll in the hay. Other neurotransmitter levels can remain constant. A 2011 study by Stony Brook University compared the brain activity of couples who had just fallen in love to couples that had been married for 21 years on average. Those dopamine centers in the brain associated with reward and pleasure were just as rich in the older couples as the new ones. So over time, they had gotten more comfortable, but still felt just as happy. We can't do D News episodes without our sponsors, so we'd like to thank K Jewelers for sponsoring this episode. For 100 years, every kiss begins with K. You may not be in a relationship right now, but still want to feel some of that touchy-feely goodness. So, can you make someone fall in love with you? Find out here. Which do you prefer, intense romance or long-term love? Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time on D News.